When the military ambulances rolled out of Chelsea barracks on a wet November night, few people imagined they'd still be on active duty today. There was apprehension among the service personnel. They'd been trained in first aid for the battlefield, not on the streets of London. This morning, those same crews were preparing to go back to normal army life, wiser and even more experienced.
You've seen a car overturn, you dive out your ambulance, you think, Jesus Christ, what do I do here? And
the thing is, we've actually proved that we can do it. At the beginning, we were told we couldn't do it, but now we've actually proved that we can.
The most disturbing was going to a cop death, I think. That's probably the worst call I've been to.
And how did that affect you?
Sleepless nights, a couple of sleepless nights, but you put it behind you, you've got to.
In the ops room, they've kept a tally of the calls they've answered, just under 60,000. 70% of them have been routine movements of old people, but they've also delivered more than a dozen babies. On the downside, two of their ambulances have been involved in fatal collisions. Despite frequent accusations that lives were lost because of the dispute, the army insists no one died through their lack of care.
The low points are very clear. It is hearing what other people's problems have been. The high points, seeing the successes and hearing the stories of success from medics who have saved a life and arrived at hospital to hand over to a casualty surgeon, and the surgeon has turned around and said, well done, you've done it right.
Throughout this dispute, the services have always maintained that they've just been doing their job, but they have been heartened by a number of telephone calls and letters they've received thanking them for doing that job. For instance, one here from a Newpey official paying tribute to his army equivalent. Another one from an elderly woman who lost her husband. She says the ambulance was here within 10 minutes, and although my husband had already died, they did all they could and were so very kind to me.
With more than 70 ambulance men and women on strike at three North London stations, pressure on the police and army today was greater than ever. The situation became even more difficult when the army vehicle at Edmonton broke down. It was left to this team at nearby Ponders Lane to cover both areas. They already deal with up to 20 emergency calls per shift. This afternoon, the work was stacked up. Many of the patients were elderly and in severe pain, some confused to be greeted by the army. The cases range from a man who'd suffered a stroke to a woman with gangrene. This team are proud they haven't lost a patient yet, but they say they can't wait to hand the job back to the professionals.
Having done this job, would you say ambulance men are only professional drivers?
Definitely not. I wouldn't do it for their money. I wouldn't do it for any money. I wouldn't want to do it full time.
So doing this, has this increased your respect for what they do?
Very much so. Very much.
As more ambulance staff threaten to join the picket lines tonight, London's ambulance chiefs warned lives would be increasingly at risk.
The level of service will undoubtedly deteriorate because there are a certain amount of calls. It doesn't matter how many calls the crews are doing. They are more calls that the police and the military will have to deal with.
With the threat of an all-out strike looming ahead, pressure on the government to settle the dispute is coming from all directions. Today, Euro MPs voted more than 2-1 for an emergency motion which calls on the government to allow the ambulance dispute to go to arbitration.
Since September, ambulance crews in the United Kingdom have been trying to negotiate with their employers in the health service for a decent wage. The British government is obstructing negotiations and has suspended workers from their jobs. The ambulance workers will accept binding arbitration, yet the British government's response has been to heap insults on the heads of those workers by comparing them to nothing more than professional drivers.
The motion was opposed by British Conservatives. They argued the common market had no authority to intervene in the dispute. Sharon Doughty for Thames News. Can we straighten this leg, Murray?